Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In the last video, we created all the pig subprograms required to move the colored boxes around. Now it's time to create the play subprograms and the main program that will bring all of our work together. Let's get started. So here's our station. We now need to create the six subprograms we need to put the boxes in the right position. So if you press forward slash, we can see we have drop light green, drop light orange, drop light yellow, drop dark green, drop dark orange, drop dark yellow, and approach green, approach orange, approach yellow. So let's create first one subprogram and let's call it app, place light green, which will be the first one. So place light green will go as follows. I'm going to move here so I can better see. Again, at some point I will show you how to have a dark background here, which would make things much easier. But again, as this is the default behavior, RoboDK will stick for this one, with this one for now. I'm going to go app green here as a joint motion. Then we will go down to drop light green with a linear motion, and we need to drop the actual box on the frame or on the tray. So here I will add a simulation event, or right click, add instruction, simulation event instruction, detach object, and I need to drop it onto the part reference frame here from the epic, the only tool I have. So I click OK, and then I will go back to my app green here with a linear motion. So I can simply copy and paste this one here. When I do copy and paste, I always go back and select the station folder here to make sure that I'm pasting it where I want here. I will use F2 to rename and select dark green. And the only thing that I have to do is change the drop light green to drop dark green here. So just like that, I can copy the first one here, Control V. This one will be placed light orange here. Open that up. Here I need to change that for app orange. I need to change that here for app orange. And I need to switch this one here for light orange. So drop light orange. So right here. So this would make this move here. I will copy that. This one here, Control V. This will be place F2, place dark orange. And I will simply switch here from drop light orange to drop dark orange. And I can do the same exact little dance one more time here for the light yellow. Here, let's switch the three targets to app yellow to drop light yellow and to app yellow like this, and I will Control C and then Control V, F2 dark yellow to rename, and then just switch the last target to dark yellow. Okay, perfect. So that's cool. So if I do a test here, if I go pick light yellow and I do place light, oops, I went for place light orange. This is not what I wanted to do. Pick light yellow and place light yellow here. That makes sense. So I can replace the object. Okay. Now let's create our main program. Again, as I already showed you, you could create the program and then use the add program call to pick, to create the programs and just list them one by one. Or you can take the shortcut where you go and select the first program you want to see, press Control, and take the select the second program you want to see. So in this case, I'm going to pick light yellow. I want to place light yellow. Then I will go and pick light orange, and I want to do place light orange. So I'm holding the Control. Then I will go and pick light green, and then place light green. I will go pick dark yellow and then place dark yellow. I will pick dark orange and then place dark orange. I will pick dark green and I will place dark green. Right click, make main program. Here, let's call it main pick and place. Call pick yellow, place light yellow, pick light orange, place light orange, pick light green, place light green, and so on and so forth. So if I run this one here, okay, that's great. Let's see if I didn't do anything wrong in this case. So I can see here where the program pointer is at. It's either in the main program or in the sub program. So call pick dark yellow, place dark yellow, pick dark orange, and then it will jump to place dark orange. So I can really follow stuff along. So good thing everything went fine because I was not looking for a second here, but my station. So that makes a lot of sense. What I can do now is add the replace object at the beginning of my program. So this way it always resets no matter what. So I can right click, add instruction, program call instruction. I will go and select my replace object, click OK, like that. And I'm going to move it before the first one. So for don't forget the little trick with the right click and hold. So right click, hold, drop, and then move before. It's always a bit hard to just with the left click drag and drop to drop it at the right position. If you want to drop it like as the first instruction, right click, hold, drag and drop, select before is way better. So now if I run this one here, everything will go back to its original position. I can hide, hide all of those targets. My bad, I shouldn't have touched that while it was running. Can increase the speed of that simulation a bit like this. I can hide the paths. Don't forget that you have two paths, one on top of the other. So you have your main path here. So if you click display path, you will still see all the paths for all the other sub programs. You can select them all in one blow and click display path. And you can do the same with the tool and with the frame. So now you have a cleaner program to show to your customer. And then if you want, you can also add folder here, and let's call this one pick here, create another one here, add folder, place. Once it's finished, okay, we can take all the place programs here, collapse that, select all of this pick. Oops, I dropped it to the wrong spot. So again, what I could have done, right click, hold, drag, drop, and nested. So this will ensure that I'm placing the objects exactly where I want them. And with that, I can run my main program once again, and everything is just fine. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for that first basic module related to pick and place applications. In the next module, we will go more in details regarding everything surrounding pick and place applications. So if you have conveyors, if you want to have animated gripper, if you want to have lights flashing to show the state of a given inspection process, let's say. We'll cover that in the next module. For this module, we still have one video left. As usual, this is a video with the bonus example where I give you an example that I do not show you exactly how to do it, and it's kind of your job to push a bit more the training and try to do it on your own. It's always a better way, I believe, to kind of cement the knowledge that you just acquired. That being said, have a great day, guys.